Look around you. You might not realize it, but you likely already live in a smart home.
Have a smart doorbell, smart thermostat, a smart baby monitor, a smart sound machine, smart assistants in every room, phones. That's right, totally forgot about phones. We rely on connectivity for pretty much everything in our life. We can't think about dead spots in our house.
Smart homes have been promised since the 1950s as a way to conquer drudgery. But now that we technically live in them, they don't feel very smart. But as smart devices flood every inch of our spaces, from light bulbs to even our toilets, it's easy to see how homes can do more than just conquer drudgery. They can take care of us.
A home that understands your habits.
Being your assistant for your daily life.
Smart spaces of the future is all about creating this perfect harmony where the network predicts what you want rather than you having to tell the machines what to do.
We are on the verge of a smart home evolution, but the question is, how do we get there? This is a story about people creating the smart technology needed to build our future smart spaces.
My name's Ben Rothwell. I'm a dad of three, a husband. So I spend a lot of time doing a lot of different things. I'm the owner of Grounded Coffee. I'm an adjunct professor for two different colleges and a pastor. If we don't have connectivity, people leave, and they leave reviews too. So the necessity of being connected is imperative for every aspect of what I do.
Wi-Fi underscores our lives, but it's not actually very reliable. It runs slow, doesn't cover the whole house, or cuts out entirely. And as we acquire more and more smart devices, this problem is only getting worse.
Nowadays, everything is smart, but the Wi-Fi hasn't really kept up with all of these devices that are being added.
And every device has a different need from the network. The chaos becomes bigger because you can't talk to all the devices at the same time.
If we're going by Moore's Law, by 2030 conservatively, there will be 125 billion Wi-Fi devices with an average of 50 in each home. But with Wi-Fi's constant communication errors, this seems unsustainable. This brings us to our central question. Do we adapt to the needs of our devices, or do they adapt to our needs? The first step was to solve the coverage issue through what's called a mesh network. This is when you extend your router's reach by placing nodes that are linked together into separate rooms. The message hops from node to node to get to its destination and evenly divides the bandwidth to all the devices.
But it's not solving the dynamic changing of the environment.
In order to solve this issue, you need to give Wi-Fi a brain. Plume did exactly that by creating adaptive Wi-Fi.
Let me show you the inside of the chamber. The idea behind adaptive Wi-Fi is learning what is the device to prioritize. So that will give a 360 measurement of the device simulating in the real environment.
A coffee maker, a doorbell, a refrigerator, it doesn't need as much bandwidth as, let's say, your laptop. And so what adaptive Wi-Fi does is it learns.
The first step is installing software on all those mesh nodes to collect information and data. Next is to communicate that information to a cloud, where it's analyzed and applied to machine learning algorithms. As it collects and stores data in real time, it sends results back into the home as the environment changes to control how the frequencies are distributed. And as it collects more data, it automatically adapts to your behaviors. Let's say you have a family where everyone is on their own device at the same time. Adaptive Wi-Fi collects information and learns that the kids need more bandwidth for streaming their show in 4K, and that mom needs less for sending emails. But both would get the bandwidth they need. In the future, where everything is connected, you can have dozens of devices working simultaneously, like an orchestra, and that just happens without you even thinking about it.
The smart space of the future can be categorized in three buckets. Personalization for IoT devices. If your coffee machine figures out a very simple pattern to brew coffee when you normally drink it, you can let your imagination run loose if you think about all the other possibilities. The second category is energy.
Your home will learn where and when you're using energy and optimize that distribution.
Forgetting turn off the lights or anything, the system able to say, lights off, there's nobody home.
And the third category is personal well-being.
Your home can know that you're waking up later, walking with a limp, or using the bathroom more.
Maybe your smart home is able to recognize that and then send an alert to one of your loved ones.
The glitz of the future is on the horizon, but for today, it's already showing promise for people like Ben in a more practical way.
About a year into the pandemic, my wife's dad had a severe cardiac arrest. So our house became this landing spot for people to come and connect. 25 people sitting in this little space, all huddled around tablets and laptops in the midst of probably the biggest trial our family ever walked through. I'm getting emotional again. So our family relied heavily on the ability to be connected. And I never once thought about, oh man, will my internet be able to do that?
Adaptive Wi-Fi's data-driven experiences are in its nascent stages. But it's clear that it's the foundation of the future smart spaces we've been promised for so long.
Sorry, I'm just making sure my two-year-old didn't wake up. I'm actually using the Plume app right now to see if my baby monitor disconnected. So what were you asking?
Thanks for watching this video made possible by Plume. If you liked it, check out freethink.com for stories about people moving the world.